Okay, today we're going to learn about microsteppers. So, what we have is a board called a A4988, and this is used to microstep for the printer. So I'm going to show you how it's connected and what you need to set up. So first, we have our X microstep port, our Y microstep port, our Z microstep port, our E0 microstep port, and then our E1 microstep port. Now over in here, we have microstep pins. These are jumpers. So we have microstep 1, 2, and 3. Now if we don't put a jumper on any of these and connect the NEMA 17 stepper motor, it'll do one full rotation, or one full step. Pardon me. If we put a jumper on MS1, we'll get a half step. If we put a jumper on MS2 only, we'll get a quarter step. If we put a jumper both on MS1 and MS2, we'll get a micro step of 8. And then if we put a jumper on all three, we'll get 16 micro steps per step. So to do this, we have to put jumpers on the actual board. So MS1, MS2, and finally MS3. That'll give us the 16 micro steps of precision that we want. In a moment, I'll show you how to actually configure your microstepping board. So give me a moment. Okay, let's take out the actual microstepping board. So we open it from the package, and there's two pieces that come with it. We have the microstep board. And then we have our heat sink, which goes on this to actually keep it cool. So in order to place it on there, what you're going to do is you're going to remove this little piece of plastic and then place it over the top. Careful not to touch any metal. And there you go. In a moment, I'll actually show you what the important pin is that we're looking for on this, and what we need to know about it. Okay, this is the top side of the microstep board, and what we're looking for is the EN pin, which is right here, and we need to line that up on the board, and in a moment I'll show you on the board where that is located. Okay, looking at the X connection for the stepper driver, you can see down in here, written on the silkscreen for the board, EN. That's the pin that we want to locate on both devices and match up when we connect. So in a moment, I'll show you how to connect them. Okay, now that we know the EN pin is over here on the board, we have to examine this closely, and we found the EN pin being right here. So in order to connect it, you just line it up over the pins. The EN pin is lined up. Apply a little bit of thumb pressure, and there you go. In a moment, I'll show you how to test it by connecting up a NEMA 17 stepper driver with the motor. And then I'll also show you how to load the firmware. Okay, so we have our NEMA 17. And then our X port is over here. So what we're going to do is we're going to plug that in. And that's how we get the motor set up. Now we also have the end stop connected over here. And in a second, I'll show you how to connect the USB port and program. Okay. Here's the USB cable. We're going to take the big side and connect it to the board. We're going to take the small side and connect it to the computer, and you're going to hear a little beep. And in a moment, I'll show you how to load the firmware. Okay, we're gonna open up the Marlin folder for 1.1.8. We're gonna open up the Marlin folder. We're gonna hit M on the keyboard, and we're gonna scroll down to marlin.ino and hit enter. We're gonna go to the configuration.h tab. We're gonna search on default underscore axis underscore steps underscore per underscore unit. And here is where the setting for the stepper drivers is configured. This is a default setting, so this is good to start with. If you want more precision, you should always go to the rep wrap calculator to find out what your configuration is. But 80 is what we're going to leave it at. So in a moment, I'm going to compile and upload. But first, I'm going to check to make sure we're connected. Looks like we're good there. And then for the board, it's an Adreno Mega architecture, so it's the same. So what we're going to do is press compile and upload. And then in a moment, I'll show you how to set up Pronerface and test. Okay, in a moment, we're going to test this in Pronerface, but first we have to plug it in. So before we plug it in, I want to emphasize that you can't touch this area once you have it energized with electricity. So in a moment, I'll show you in Pronerface how to test this. Okay, we're going to open up Pronerface. We're going to connect to the device. We're going to check the status of the end stops by typing M119 and enter. And it says the X-Min is open. So in a moment, I'm going to hit the home button for X and actuate the end stop with my finger. So now we've homed the X-axis. I'm going to advance by 10. Now I'm going to advance by 100. Now I'm going to go back by 100. So that's how to set it up. So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.